She's one of the most successful artists in Billboard history.
Janet has 18 consecutive top 10 hits, the most by any female artist in history.
Janet Jackson is a living legend.
A legend is innovative, daring, lasting. A legend changes the face of the industry.
She's just an unbelievable legend and such a talent. Somebody that I really, really look up to.
Rhythm Nation was a huge inspiration for, like, my first single went out, like, a couple years ago. And she was just, like, just her whole, like, aura just, I think, inspires so many young women and so many young artists.
My biggest influence growing up was Janet Jackson.
When I was growing up, there was no Rihanna, there was no Beyonce, there was Janet Jackson. And she's just a pioneer in the music industry. And I'm sure those girls would say it too, like, well, we all looked up to her. And, you know, she'll always have it, and she'll always be Janet Jackson. Or Miss Jackson, if you're nasty.
When I saw the Pleasure Principle, it inspired me to get into this business.
You have achieved so much and will only keep climbing higher and higher. Your talent knows no boundaries. I love you, and I am honored and proud to be your brother.
I love her. Bow down. Yes, yes. She's great. She's really good. Rhythm Nation. I still listen to that.
I loved Janet Jackson when I was growing up.
Miss Jackson, if you're nasty. Mm-hmm.
One of my favorite things as a kid was, like, Rhythm Nation.
She can act, she can dance, she can sing, and she's a Jackson. She got it all.
To this day, still touring, still singing, still looking fabulous.
A better measure of her influence and staying power is the effect you continue to see her have on other performers. She has constantly and consistently driven the culture forward. That is Janet.
This woman would become Janet Jackson.
She had a very domineering and dictatorial father.
I felt I can't be the only young adult in this world that is experiencing these feelings.
My father worked in the steel mill. He was a crane operator. He was a hard worker. And my father did whatever it took to feed his children. Gary is rough, and he didn't want his kids on the street. He didn't want his kids doing drugs. He didn't want his kids being alcoholics. My father wanted a better life for us, and he saw performing as our way out.
Musically speaking, did you study a lot before this record?
To be honest with you, no, I didn't. When I was younger, for 1 month, I took piano lessons, and I quit because my brother Randy quit, and I didn't want to take a loan. So I just started playing by ear, and that's how that came together. I was 2 years old when my brothers had their first number one, which was the first single, I Want You Back, and I just grew up being in the business, and I learned a lot just by watching.
So many kids in the house, and from country to blues to classical to jazz and R&B and pop and folk. All that stuff was going throughout the house, so I'm so happy that I was the ninth child to be bombarded with all of this in such a great way that it has filtered into my songwriting.
They obviously saw something within me that I never knew was truly there, that I could do this, that I wouldn't freeze up, that I wouldn't get stage fright.
Come here, little boy.
What's your name, little sister?
Janet.
How do you like being a part of Jackson 5?
I like it.
What do you do?
Sing and dance.
It was sad when my brothers would go on tour,
because the house was empty. And it was just my mother and my sister and myself. And I was very close to my brothers.
Very early on, we saw that she had a very clear idea about doing something different for herself.
Yes, the beat goes on.
I was doing the Jacksons television summer specials, and it just so happens that Norman Lear, who did Sanford and Son, All in the Family, Jeffersons, I mean, so many good times, so many different shows, Maude, happened to see me, and they needed to cast a young girl. They called me in for an interview, and we did this improv, and he loved the way that it went. It got very emotional. I didn't know what I was doing. I was just going with what I felt, I guess, in my gut. And as I was walking out of the building, he said, if you want to have the part, you can, it's yours. So that's how, I was just 10 years old.
She's pretty much grown up as pop royalty from the day she was born. And so I think people don't always understand how much credit she has to be given for her real acting chops at a very young age.
Now the world don't move.
It became a big success with black people and white people because the concept was universal, because it really was just about love.
I want to meet my sister Kimberly and my little brother.
From what I'm hearing, Todd had a crush on me, and that's how I got the job.
When I got her on the show, the plan was, you know, for me to start dating her. That was my plan.
He wanted me to be his girlfriend in the show, so I was his girlfriend in the show.
Well, we were definitely had a natural attraction towards one another. Do the hustle.
I was shocked to see my little sister growing up so fast. She did like a little love thing where she was had a little kissing role on there. It was hard for me to see that.
Janet, it was my first love. And I still love Janet. I always will. But she has a special place in my heart.
I've watched my brothers all through the years, and I've learned a lot from them. Plus, we have a studio at home, and when I was younger, I used to write a great deal. Just go in whenever we felt like it and put a little demo down.
I wanted my own identity so badly. I didn't want people to know that I was a Jackson. In the very, very beginning, it's just a matter of going to the studio, doing what they want you to do, and then you leave, and that's it.
But beneath her bubblegum image was a shy young woman who had struggled with a childhood in the limelight, where decisions were made for her. A Janet still recovering from the shattering end of an early marriage. A Janet who, at 18, needed desperately to break free and become her own person.
When I got with Jimmy and Terry, I decided to change that, and they welcomed it with open arms. I remember my father saying, I don't want my daughter sounding like Prince. Don't make her sound like Prince, because of the whole Minneapolis sound and Jimmy and Terry being a part of the time. The reason why we named it Control is I'm taking more control of my career as well as my life.
No, my first name ain't Baby. It's Janet. Miss Jackson, if you're nasty. Nasty boys, but don't do anything.
Jimmy and Terry are two of the nicest guys that I know. They're incredible. We had the best time. I love them so much.
I pretty much sat down and talked with them, told them everything that I felt I needed to tell them about my life and everything that I had gone through, and I told them I needed them to help express my feelings, you know, and we just wrote the stuff together and picked what we liked best.
Janet Jackson, Control is like one of the most classic albums, and also I think that she took videos to another level as a female.
For the young girls, like myself at the time, I looked at her and was just like, now that's how I gotta do it.
Thank you.
something.
Tiananmen Square today.
Up to the adults to teach the children.
Period. A pain reliever. The bullets.
Attempting fast money.
Violent crimes are on the uprise.
So frustrating.
Nation is a collection of music built around a core of ideals that promote humanity and education. To make a true impact, Janet wanted to do more than just make the standard 4-minute video. She wanted to do a full-length movie.
The album and the film is about people united through dance and music, dealing with a lot of the social problems we have. I feel that there's one thing that we all have in common, and that's music. I know a song can't change the world, but if our music could inspire some of the people and make them want to join hands and begin to deal with a lot of the social problems we have, then hopefully we could make some sort of progress. And that's pretty much what it's all about. I've always been concerned with the children and the homeless and illiteracy, racism, and things like that. And I think it's just time that we need to really do something about it. And that's pretty much really what triggered this entire idea.
We're all role models, whether we want to be or not. That is it. We are.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
There was really no one doing the type of music that I do that was doing anything like that. So I thought that was really important to touch a certain generation, a certain group, demographic, to give them some sort of, or at least try, some sort of guidance. I speak with kids and they tell me something that I've done has affected their life in a positive way. That's when I feel so good about what I'm doing and I'm so happy that I did it. Because that's what's important to me. That's the most important thing to me. Because the kids are the future, our future, and I've always said that. It's time to give a damn, let's
work together. We would watch a lot of TV, and the TV would constantly be switching between MTV and CNN.
They have a lot of documentaries with prostitution, child abuse, drugs.
We could have called the record Escapade, and then put the 4 or 5 more conscious cuts at the end of the record. But her thing was, no, we got to start the record. Boom, boom, state of the world, the knowledge. You know, I think the record company was a little bit like, pretty heavy stuff.
Well, I got my way.
Even as Rhythm Nation outsold Control, its underlying message created a new social consciousness in fans worldwide. And on the road, she put her money where her mouth was. But Janet's dedication reached a new level with the touching story of Kia and Keisha Croft, two sisters who had dropped out of school.
I know some people don't think a song on an album can change your life. But that's so in our case. By listening to your song, the knowledge it made us realize how important an education is. Thank you so much.
They listened to that song and it just turned their lives completely around. They graduated from high school and went on to college from there. And they actually gave me their tassels. And I thought that was the sweetest thing. So I wanted to give something back, so I had them framed. And I gave them back to them because they did the hard work.
Since Michael Jackson's Thriller has an artist dominate the field so completely, and never before in history has a woman won this unprecedented number of awards. All this at the tender age of 24. Ladies and gentlemen, the remarkable spirit of Rhythm Nation Miss Janet Jackson!
Ladies and gentlemen, the 1990 Video Vanguard Award winner, the queen, pop, soul, country, everything, Miss Janet Jackson!
I had a great deal of faith in myself. And the Rhythm Nation album was even more successful than the Control album. People of the world unite, strip the numbers, we can
get it right one time. Atlantic News, Janet Jackson, who just a week ago signed what is reported to be a $50 million deal with Virgin Records, was honored as Humanitarian of the Year by the Starlight Foundation of Southern California, the organization that makes wishes come true for seriously ill children.
Alone. Lying thinking last night, how to find my soul a home, where water is not thirsty and bread loaf is not stone. I came up with one thing, and I don't believe I'm wrong, that nobody, but nobody can make it out here alone.
Okay, you are embarking on a new project, you have a new album, a new record label. Tell us about the album and how the project evolved.
During Rhythm Nation, it was an idea that I had to go a little further, do something that I hadn't done before, basically trying to do that with each project. And it's about love, the highs and the lows of love. That's what this album is about.
As you grow, so does your audience. There's so many different things that we experience in life, and why not write about them? Whether they're joyful or sad.
Janet Jackson's dreams are coming true. With three consecutive multi-platinum albums and record-breaking concert performances, Janet is one of the world's most successful recording artists. Sitting over here staring in your face with a look to my eyes, sure I don't give a damn, and you don't know that I have been thinking of being all I've ever seen. You never want you to look at me, don't even realize that I'm wanting you. Do you think that you might need to think of what you want, let your mind free, run free to a place no one. Basically, all of the songs on the album, I can't write about something that I don't feel in my heart, that I haven't experienced in my life at some point or another. And If is basically, it's about fantasizing, and with all the songs on the album, writing them, it's something that's happened to me in my past, or really my past, or something in the present that's happening. But with If, it's about fantasizing. This girl is fantasizing about this guy and what she'd do to him if they were together. And I mean, I'm guilty because I've definitely done that. And I think pretty much everyone has done that at some point in their life.
I heard from a friend today, and she said you were in town. Suddenly the memories came back to me in my mind.
I couldn't believe it at first. I was going, oh my God. I just could not believe it. It's a dream come true. It really is. I've thought about this since I was a little girl.
My mother called me up, and she was just so, she knew how badly I wanted the nomination, and she just kept congratulating me.
For some people, it's kind of, I guess, hard for her. She's talking about, you know, sex, and, mm-hmm. and so...
I've had a guy actually come up to me when the Janet album had just come out, and he goes, oh, what are you doing? You're telling our kids to have sex. And he said, what happened to let's wait a while? And I said to him, look, at how long do you want me to wait? I'm almost 30. You know, it's... I don't know, it seems like a lot of times certain people do expect you to raise their children for them. I know that every person, whether you want to be or not, yes, you are a role model. You have to be careful about what you say and do, but at the same time, you have to be true to yourself. You really do. And they have to also understand that as parents, they're role models as well.
Thank you.
you always hope that your project is successful, but I never knew the extent that it was, the success was going to be, really.
So why don't we start with Runaway and how you came to write it and what it was about and so forth.
Well, basically, Runaway is pretty much about my experiences going to different countries, being around the world, all the beautiful places. It's about all the experiences that I've had, all the beautiful experiences and the different races of people that I've made friends with. And everything was so wonderful, but there was one thing that was missing, and that was you, the person that I love.
The one thing missing was you.
When Jimmy Jam was talking about that, he looked at the tune as an homage to your fans, did
yeah,
that?
Yeah, you could definitely. I mean, it would definitely be an homage to the fans. Runaway was hard. Aside from the heat, there was so much we had to do, and we only had 2 days for me to shoot. I give it my all, 150%. If that's what they're trying to capture, and I think it's a great idea too, then 200%.
Start facing this way, but just do hip roll, right into pull. So that you're moving as you get into the...
I've talked about being such a tomboy growing up and having six brothers. Whatever my brothers did, that's what I want to do. I was always in the middle of everything, messing up everything, but they never kicked me out.
I feel really, you don't look girly. I feel like a female.
And then to do something so feminine, it was just very, very girly. And sometimes I feel very awkward. Like, oh God, this doesn't look right on me. Do I look like a man trying to... all rough, trying to sway your hips. And she kept going, please do it, please. I said, okay, I'll do it.
In 1996, Jackson renewed a contract with Virgin Records for a record-breaking $80 million. Giselle Fernandez spoke with Janet in 1998 during her European tour about it.
The highest-paid performer of all time.
Oh, God.
How do you deal with that?
How do I deal with it?
Yeah.
I don't think about that. I don't think about that at all.
How do you handle the confusion? Where do you put the frustration? I know a place. That lifts the fog and eases the pain.
Where does the velvet rope sort of, does this work as a metaphor in terms of velvet ropes we put up to shut people out, in terms of, you
know, shut people out, not letting people get to know us, not letting us get to know ourselves even. It's like your protective shield in a way, or what you think is your protective shield that really, really can hurt you.
Her most personal album yet, written and recorded during a period of self-acknowledged depression.
It's childhood, it's my teenage years, my adulthood, lots of things that I've just carried with myself, around with me. And I had my escapism so that I wouldn't feel that pain. It took six and a half months to make the album. When before, Control took 2.5 months, RN took three, mm-hmm. Janet took 3.5. This took six and a half months because I had to take so many breaks. It was too much for me, and I'd had to leave, go away for a week, take a break, and then come back and continue. And there were times when I didn't think I was going to complete it. Mm-hmm. I really didn't, and I did, obviously. Some ask, was that something that happened in my life? Yes.
because I do write what's going on in my life, but writing that album and going through what I was going through, it was so hard and cathartic, very therapeutic. Thank God I had people in my life that were so supportive and understood and helped me to continue and write about the rest of what was going on in my life.
I write about what's in my life and what moves me in hopes that it will move someone else in a positive way. I think I'm independent, but I think it's very important to hear what others have to say and listen and then, you know, make your own decision from there. More so than anything, I think it's thought-provoking and it makes the listener think about what's going on in their life and possibly, hopefully, it will make them want to, you know, make a few changes within their life for the better. Together Again does please me that it has been received as well as it has. I mean, Renee called it from day one. He knew it was going to be a number one song all over the country, and it's done the same in Europe. I mean, it's been incredibly successful, and they're still playing it. Well, normally they'd be on to the next single by now, but they won't let go of it, and I'm thankful that they're enjoying it so much. I've been very fortunate so far and releasing singles that have the public has really embraced, really. Some of them do just pop out at you, like Together Again or I Get Lonely, and then from there you gotta go with what you feel in your heart would be best, really.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the recipient of the 1997 Soul Train Lady of Soul Awards, the Lena Horne Award for Outstanding Career Achievement, Miss Janet Jackson.
Life can sometimes take turns that even the most skilled navigators cannot anticipate. Thankfully, many of us have the support and love of others to help us stay on our path and to help us meet our goals and dreams. Receiving this award is a great honor, and I am very grateful to all of you for this recognition.
This would be cool if these are two different colors right here. Like if you wanted to have this orange and that red.
No, I didn't mean to do that, but that is kind of cool.
Because it could still be a piece.
Tired ass drawings.
What section of the show is this for?
This is the whimsical, but I'm changing my outfit for the States. Because it's...
All of them?
No, just mine. It's a little hot, and my hat is very heavy.
What is yours like?
Well, this is me trying to draw. See, so I was trying to figure... I hate showing you guys. This is so bad.
No, it's cool.
But something like this. It's more the feeling. So it's kind of a cross between what I did last time.
You forgot to put in your cleavage.
The infamous cleavage. It got you in trouble. Was it Hartford, Connecticut?
Yeah. Those people don't have any identity. They don't. Cleavage? Come on. There are more important things happening in the world.
Privacy. Janet has always tried to stay out of the public eye, but she agreed to sit down with Ed Gordon on the BET special The Journey to Janet to talk about some shocking news in the headlines.
We ended up doing the interview right after it was announced that she had been married secretly to Renee Elizondo for a number of years and no one knew. She was doing a movie then, and we had scheduled an interview to really talk around that movie. When that news broke, we just knew that we were going to get a call from her management to say that the interview was off. And we did get a call. She had told them she was comfortable with me asking her some of those questions. And I appreciate that she didn't run away from it.
Can you share with the public what you'd want them to know at this point?
It's just a really sad thing, you know, for it to happen. Unfortunately, life is ever changing, and I'm in a new space now and in a much happier place.
It was a big step for her. And again, I took pride in knowing that I was going to deliver that story and deliver what she wanted to viewers in a way that was authentic.
Press accounts said that you suggested it had nothing to do with keeping a, quote, sexy image. It was about trying to keep a marriage together and your privacy.
Growing up in this business, always being in the public eye, and I've always felt that it's that you're never given a fair chance. Immediately when they know that, you know, some people try to knock it or it won't last, or some people say, well, I'll give it 6 months or I'll give it a year, and that's such negative energy. That's such negative energy going into such a beautiful thing. And I wanted my privacy and to try and have a true normal family life as much as I possibly could.
Music made her a superstar. We made her an icon.
Edit.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Well, my life has changed. It seems like it keeps changing. There will be lots of new me's. I'm looking forward to meeting them all. My life has changed a great deal. And that's why there's a new, freer me.
Guess I'm gonna have to ride it tonight. Tonight.
It's all for you. I just write what I'm feeling in my heart. It goes on in my life. You know, as a kid, I could never keep a journal. I could never keep a diary, and I tried. And I saw other kids do it, and I thought I was just weird or different in that way. And then I came to realize as I got older that my albums are my journals. Someone to call my lover. I remember singing it over the phone for Jimmy, and he kept going, this is a hit, this is a hit. He goes, you have to come back to Minneapolis and record it. And it was just released, but people seem to be enjoying it.
Edit.
is sick. Attention, it's time to dance.
Work it like you're working a pole. Shake it till you're shaking the floor. Pop it like you're popping a cork. Don't stop, don't stop. Jerk it like you're making a choke.
Like that.
Break it like you're breaking a code.
Like that.
Drop it till you're taking a load.
Like that.
I could dance all night.
This has taken me the longest, this album, to make. But I mean, there were some reasons why. There was a lot of stopping and starting. It took about maybe 18 months. It took quite a while. In the past, at the longest had been 6 months. Control took 2.5 months to do. Rhythm Nation took 3. So this is really different. But for me, for it to take this long to spew out an album, but there's good reason for it. I guess I am divulging a little bit more of myself on this album, and it's definitely much more intimate. And that's another side of myself that people have seen, but not to this level. It shows the different sides of me, the different characters that I feel that I display at different moments in my life. I've always wanted to do an album where the music is a complete departure from what people know me for, and I really didn't want anyone to know that it was me singing on the album. I was going to title it Demita Joe, which is my middle name, and when Dallas and I were sharing our middle names with one another, he had said to me, that's what you should call the album, and I thought, you know what, he's right, I shouldn't wait to do that, I should just use it now. Demita Joe is definitely who I am today. In all her schizophrenic personalities.
Don't stop!
So just sign my name.
Yeah. And then hold it in front of you. What's your involvement in this project?
I'm one of the principals.
Okay. And this is the first video for the new album, right?
Yes, 20 years old.
Okay, here you can put that down. Now we can talk about the new album.
Oh.
And I'll let you read these. They're really fun.
Okay.
This is a soul, soul, death, world, world,
From day one, I've always been very close to Jimmy. He picked me up from the airport when I was just a baby. I was only, 19, 18? To start on the Control album, I flew to Minneapolis. And we've been like this ever since. Very, very close. There's nothing he can't do.
It sounds like it's for the club, heavy for the club.
Peony, this microphone's too short, Ian.
Scooch.
Who said that, Jermaine?
Man. That's the secret.
KX is Granite, it's me, Jen, and welcome to day one of my new video. I'm so excited.
Roll playback.
It's a song that every
everybody is dancing to Feedback from her new CD Discipline that's blown up the charts. She's a true superstar, and I want to bring her out right now. And I need to hear some feedback. Not that you need to.
Extreme facts to my Asian persuasion. I got it all. That's why these girls out here hating. Cause I'm sexy, cause I'm sexy. Hey, yeah, sexy, sexy, sexy. Cause I'm sexy, cause I'm sexy. Hey, yeah, sexy, sexy, sexy. Sexy, 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 sexy. Sexy, 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 sexy. Sexy, 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 sexy. Sexy, 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 sexy.
I know.
And that's what Janet, that's what our fans want to see, that's what I want to see, what the record label wants to see, and right now where we're at, we need to give the people what they want.
It's a club video. Have you ever heard of the Blitz Kids? The Blitz Kids were a group of club kids in England in the 80s that went to a club called Blitz. And this is kind of a takeoff from that, even though they were way more far out than what you see us, but it's like the Blitz Kids of 2008. And it's actually the first kind of club video that I've ever done.
Heart. My brother, the legendary king of pop, Michael Jackson, passed away on Thursday, June 25th, 2009 at 2:26 p.m.
My entire family wanted to be here tonight, but it was just too painful. So They elected me to speak with all of you, and I'm going to keep it very short, but I'd just like to say that to you, Michael is an icon. To us, Michael is family. And he will forever live in all of our hearts. On behalf of my family and myself, thank you for all of your love. Thank you for all of your support. We miss him so much. Thank you so much.
It's me, Janet. During these past several months, I've had such wonderful experiences. I've released my number one CD. I co-wrote the theme song for Nothing, for the motion picture Why Did I Get Married To? And I starred in the film for Colored Girls, and I also completed my first book, True You. And throughout this time, I've heard from all of you, my fans, whose love I cherish and support I cherish dearly. Many have asked, when will I tour again? Well, today I'm really excited to answer that question and to announce.
promised you'd hear it from my lips, and now you will. This year, new music, new world tour, a new movement. I've been listening. Let's keep the conversation going.
Hey, you guys, it's me, Jan. Just in case you don't recognize me, because I have put on quite a few since I had my baby. But I thank God. I thank God for him, you guys. He is so healthy, so beautiful, so sweet, so loving, such a happy baby. This message was supposed to be about something else, but I'll get to that in a minute. I just want to keep it real with you guys for a second. Yes, I separated from my husband. We are in court, and the rest is in God's hands. Now for that something else. I'm continuing my tour as I promised. I decided to change the name of the tour, State of the World Tour. It's not about politics. It's about people, the world, relationships, and just love. I want to thank you guys for your patience, for all of your support throughout the years. Thank you so much. I am so excited. I cannot wait to see you on stage September 7th. Bye.
Woo! much come to remember. If I hit you, too strong, but you don't know. Can hurt you better. Take it from me, you brought that rat and set for a better day. And to get educated for a better way. As soon as you wanna be in control, you gotta get yourself in the
know. You know I came to snatch a couple of wings.
I'm deeply humbled and grateful for this award. So again, I want to thank all of you for this honor.
It is truly an honor to be here tonight to help present the 2018 RDMA Impact Award. This supernova, whom I'm blessed enough to breathe the same air as, has had such a lasting impact on this industry and on many little girls like myself growing up wanting to be just like her.
Look, I have made it publicly clear that Janet Jackson is my one and only icon. I too grew up watching her and idolizing her. This moment is a dream come true. Now, I've embarrassed myself enough in front of her, so tonight I must redeem myself. You, Janet Jackson, have embodied the essence of multi-generational mega-iconism. Every album, appearance, tour, video, every comeback, every installment of you to the public is uniquely crafted in fierceness, okay? You are the essence of art. You are the goddess of performance. You are the groove queen. You have entertained us your entire life, and you never let us down. Now, it is our honor to present Janet Jackson with the first ever RDMA Impact Award, which from this day forward will be called the Janet Jackson Impact Award.
So it's my great honor to introduce the legendary Janet Jackson.
If you live it for the moment, oh, don't stop, celebrate the feel.
No,
grow up if you live it for the moment. Stop, cause they break them ceilings.
grace, beauty, and strength has created an exemplary path for generations of women. And for that, we thank you. Please accept the Black Girls Rock Rockstar Award. You rock, Janet.
So Janet, the Icon Award says to Janet Jackson for your unique and indelible influence on generations of music makers. Congratulations from BMI.
We celebrate you for fighting for women's rights. We celebrate you for going high when they go low. We celebrate you for being an ally to the LGBTQIA plus communities and marginalized voices around the world. History is not complete without you, Janet. That's why we bow at your altar tonight. We say thank you. And it's now, yes, and it is now your time. Everyone in here, I want y'all to get up on your feet, get up out your seat, and I want you to stand and welcome Miss Janet Jackson into the Rock and Roll Hall.
Metamorphosis can and will continue to bring out the essential beauty of our souls.
Jackson shows at the Blaisdell, she held up the sign of the Mauna Kea protesters.
The singer did not talk about it during her shows, but tonight she reveals why she's taking a stand.
To be able to want to take this land and sacred land, it's wrong. It's not right at all. And I stand with them.
Janet Jackson is talking about this moment in her concerts in Honolulu when she shows her support for the TMT protest at Mauna Kea. As pictures of the protesters are shown on stage, she and her dancers flash the sign signifying the Mauna.
There are a few Hawaiians that have been in my camp for a while, for a good while, more than 15 years. They were explaining to me the situation, and I was floored.
Thank you for coming back to our show. I'm so excited that you're here. And I just read some amazing things about you, all true. And there was more stuff I wanted to talk about. I didn't know you have an Oscar nomination for Best
Yes.
Original Song.
Yes.
You're the first woman to be nominated for a Producer of the Year Grammy.
Yes.
You have 27 top 10 hits.
Yes.
You have the record for most consecutive top 10 hits on the U.S. Billboard Hot 100 chart by a female artist. And you're the first and only artist in history to have 7 top 5 hits from one album. You are unbelievable. You're iconic. Just to tell you some nice things about you.
Is it
embarrassing?
Yes.
Sorry about that.
Like you've never seen her before. Live across North America.
Just think of you, 'cause when I think of you,